Hi, this is Rich. How you doing? So we're going to have a conversation here about Christ, what the word means. I'm studying Neville Goddard's awakened imagination stuff to help manifest a better life for myself. And the Christ within, Jesus Christ in the Bible, says Neville, is our own human imagination. So it's just a really a big handful, and as I work out how my awakened imagination is Jesus Christ, it occurred to me the word Christ itself can be a thing. In my own head, to have a really profound understanding of the entire concepts we're dealing with, it would be a really good idea to get crystal clear on Christ so I can understand Jesus Christ in the Bible, and also Jesus Christ as the awakened human imagination, or the awakened imagination. Okay, and I'm going to ask ChatGPT to help me with it. Okay, here we go.
Hi, Rich. It's great to be here with you, diving deep into the understanding of the word Christ. It's such a profound and multifaceted concept, especially when viewed through the lens of Neville Goddard's teachings. So let's get started. The word Christ originates from the Greek word Christos, which means anointed one. It's a translation of the Hebrew word Messiah. But let's break it down further. What does it mean to be anointed? Historically, being anointed meant being chosen by God for a specific purpose, often through a ceremonial act of pouring oil. But now let's bring this back to Neville Goddard. When he talks about Jesus Christ as the human imagination, he suggests that Christ represents a state of consciousness, the awakened imagination that realizes its own creative power. This implies that Christ isn't just a title reserved for Jesus of Nazareth, but is a state of being that anyone can attain through spiritual awakening and the realization of their own creative potential. The concept of being Christed or anointed symbolizes a profound internal transformation. When we talk about Christ within us, we're talking about reaching a state of higher consciousness where we recognize and embrace our divine nature and creative power. Neville Goddard's teachings emphasize that this anointing or christening is a metaphor for awakening to the realization that our imagination is the source of our reality. It's about recognizing that the same divine creative force attributed to Jesus Christ exists within each of us. By elevating our consciousness, we metaphorically anoint ourselves, acknowledging our inherent divinity and the power of our imagination to shape our lives. Mm-hmm. So how do you think this process of elevating your consciousness and embracing your inner Christ has influenced your own life and manifestation practices so far?
Well, I've noticed already that manifestation is working better. But what I'm doing is elevating my consciousness and awareness of the phenomena of imagination. And I realize that everything I'm thinking day to day, 24/7, is within my imagination. The things that I'm wondering about, just day to day, you know, I wonder if I got enough coffee to last me the week, or you know, I wonder how much fuel is in the propane tanks. And I'm thinking, well, I think I got enough. Is this my imagining? Am I imagining if I've got enough or not? It's a thought. It's a consideration. Is there a difference between thinking, pondering, wondering, and imagining? What? How does it all fit, really? So I've been looking into this, studying this, really getting into it, so I can understand what I'm doing here with my imagination, because I want to be more aware and in more control, be more responsible for what I'm imagining. Because I believe that everything I'm thinking and imagining is going into that the world of the unseen. And there's that deeper divine aspect of God consciousness within me? Like Christ and God are within me? The Father and the Son are one, all of that. But if that's just the imagining, and it's the, you know, I'm a God spark, but I'm relatively asleep or unaware of my God power, but the God power still exists within me with my thoughts. And just like I could close my eyes and imagine an apple, and there's an apple. Instant manifestation, right? In the unseen. But if I load in there, that's not a real apple, or if I have a thought, an imagining that, well, it's not a real apple, it's just an imaginary apple, and I can see it and it's red, but yeah, it's not real. All those thoughts that I'm not really aware of, and I thought yesterday and last week and 100 years ago or 1,000 years ago, are all these within the depth of my imagining? And it's this imagination that I have. It's the part of me that is asleep to how powerful my imagination is. So I'll think one thing and I'll think contrary the next day or the next week or the next year. I'll want something now, and you know, because it doesn't manifest, because I was thinking I wanted something else earlier. Now I don't want this anymore. Now I want something else. And it keeps, you know, I'm going to get a new car, but I think I want to, you know, something snappy and fast and fun. And then I test drive a few of those, and then I go, no, maybe I want a pickup truck or an SUV. Yeah, now that I think about it, or you've talked to a friend or a family member and you change your mind. So you think one thing and you change your mind, you think another. One day you love somebody and the next day you don't like them anymore. Or you used to like your boss and now you don't like your boss. You used to love your job, now you hate it. Or you didn't used to like it, now you love it. All this stuff is like the unawakened imagination in process, always. And it goes into the unseen world or realm of the imagination, and the deeper God creative aspect of consciousness and self takes all, factors all of that in, and what is materialized in this plane is the culmination of all of that. So now this is the life I have. So embracing this inner Christ is embracing this imagination, but in an awakened state. So it's really me being more awake as regards my imagination, what I'm imagining, and how powerful it is. So I realized that you really have to be disciplined. You got to have faith in the imagining. And you, for me, responsible for what I'm thinking, what I'm imagining. And so all of a sudden, the idea of what, how this works, and what it really means to have an awakened imagination, or what it really means to have Christ, is the awakened imagination. So this Christ, Jesus Christ within me, could be looked at or viewed as an aspect of myself, like the inner child, the warrior within, the wounded healer, the sage, aspects, archetypes of self, ego stuff. There's a part of me that is the aspect of self, the me, the I am, that's the God, the name of God, I am that I am. I am God incarnate. I am a Son of God. I am Christ. But this is the idea of me waking up this other aspect of myself that lays sleeping and dormant, or let's say I am asleep relative to my Christed consciousness, my awake and aware self that is totally aware of how incredibly powerful I am as a son of God, right? This me is asleep to that. So I am waking up to be one with this other aspect of myself, okay? And we could say, the other aspect of myself is asleep, or no, it's this aspect of myself is somewhat less aware and less conscious of the profound aspect of the divine within me. Kind of like that. Jeez.
Wow, Rich, that's a deep and insightful dive into how elevating your consciousness and embracing your inner Christ has influenced your life and manifestation practices. It's clear that you're deeply committed to understanding and mastering this process. Let's unpack some of what you've shared.
Okay.
You mentioned that everything you think and ponder is within your imagination, and you're trying to differentiate between mere thinking and the act of imagining.